All right, everybody, it is math time, and it is time to subtract. Check out this picture I have to show you. Whoa! What a cool-looking picture! Look at all these subtraction problems. Oh my gosh, last time we were looking at the addition table, now we're looking at the subtraction table. Here's all the facts that we just need to know off the top of our head. And the first set of facts that I have highlighted are the zero facts. Again, zeros are the best. They're worth nothing, but they are worth something. They are so awesome. Check it out. Let's check this one. We have nine toys. And we're like, my gosh, I have so many toys. I am going to give some away. And you decide to actually give none to your sister. So how many do you have left to give to your friends? You actually still have nine because you gave your sister nothing. Gosh, your sister should get something. So our zero facts, we just get what we had before. That's awesome. Let's check out some other facts. Now we have called the count back facts. Now notice in this one, we are counting back just one. Then we're counting back two and we're counting back three. So if we see a subtraction like this one, nine, and then we see we're subtracting three, what can we do to figure that out? We could just count back because three is not that many to count back. So if we're at nine, then we'd count backwards because we're subtracting and go 8, 7, 6. And cha-ching, we have our difference is 6. Awesome. Okay, so those are great. Let's go to another set. Check out the blue. These are called take all. And why are they called take all? Because, well, look at this one. If I have 8 toys and I give 8 of them away, how many am I gonna have left? 9. You gave them all away. Like all of them. You're taking all of them away, so you have nothing. Nothing! Such a great person that you gave all your toys away. Okay? So we're always just left with zero because we took everything away. So those are great facts too. So look at that. Zero, count back, and take all. Wow, that's a lot of facts already off the table. Let's check out some other ones. Whoa, now we go to the awesome color of purple. And these are called neighbors. Neighbors, why are they called neighbors? Well, let's look at this one. You have 7 being subtracted with 6. What do you think? Why would we call it neighbor facts? Well, 6 and 7, they're neighbors. They're like right next to each other when we count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They're right there next to each other. Neighbors looking at each other saying, oh, hi, neighbor. So the 6 is looking at the 7. Like, oh my gosh, hello, neighbor. We live right next to each other. You're my neighbor. They are just how far away from each other? They're 1 away from each other. Their difference is 1. So instead of counting back 6, that's a lot to do to go 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and get an answer of 1. Yes, it works. But just knowing that they're neighbors and looking at it as the difference makes it so much easier and quicker. Now you could also think of a problem like this as a neighbor fact. 11 minusing 9. And you might be like, well, they're not neighbors. Well, they are close neighbors. You know those houses where wherever you live, the people aren't like right next to you, but they're kind of close to you? They're still considered your neighborhood. So 9 and 11 are in the same neighborhood. They're pretty close to each other. So when I'm counting, I go 9, right? 10, 11. How far away is 9 from 11? What's the difference there? What's the difference? It's not just a difference of 1, it's actually a difference of 2, okay? So neighborhoods exist with a difference of 1 and a difference of 2. They're neighbors. Such nice to be neighbors. All right, let's look at another set. These are called the takeaway 10. What does that mean? Well, it means you take away 10. So if I had like 16 of something and I take 10 of it away? Oh gosh, let's check that one out on a number rack. Actually, I don't have a number rack up. So if I have 16 on my number rack, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then I have another 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then I go 16, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and I need to take away 10? Well, here's the 10 I'm gonna take away. If I take away those 10, guess what I have left? I have the 6 left. Awesome, that works out nice. And why is that? Because 6 plus 10 gives me 16. Awesome. And it works out that way every time. 14 minus 10 is 4. 13 minus 10 is 3. 18 minus 10, 8. Right? It's so awesome. Take away 10. Another set. We have the set in gray. Now, these are called the back to 10 facts. So if I have like 15, and I'm minusing 5, that gets me back, because if I'm at 15 on the number line and I go backwards, what number am I gonna hit if I go back 5? Oh man, well, it 5 shows up right here. If I go back 5, I'm gonna be back at what? 10. That's why it's called the back to 10 facts. Because I'm at 14 and I'm minus 4, I'll be back at 10. 16 minus 6, I'll be back at 10, right? It'll be back at 10. All right, we have some more. Take half facts. Check out the red ones. Why are these called take half? Because let's check out the most famous one ever. 10 and we take away 5. We're gonna be back at what? 5, because 5 is half of 10 and 5 plus 5 is 10, the doubles facts coming into play. So 12 minus 6, what would that equal? 6, because 6 and 6 is 12. If I had 14 and I see the subtraction problem minus 7, my face gets super excited because I know 7 and 7 is 14. So the answer to this would just be 7. So awesome, okay? Another set of facts to know are called the up to 10s. Okay, and these are in dark blue. These are a little interesting, so check this out. If I am gonna go to this one here that tricks people up, if I have 13 and I'm minusing 6, and we call it up to 10, because 10 is such a lovely number, so we wanna like somehow work in 10. So on a number line, instead of starting at 1, I'm gonna put these two numbers on there. So which number is smaller, 6 or 13? Say it out loud. I can't hear you, you have to say it louder. Good job, it is 6. And the other number, 13. Okay, we need to find this, the difference. Are they neighbors? No, they are not within 1 or 2 of each other. How far are they from each other? Now, an easy way to figure that out is to say, well, 10 is somewhere in here. And if I can get what's on either side of 10, quickly, then I can get my difference quickly. So if I'm at 6, how many more do I need to make 10? Well, if I have 6, how many more to make 10? It's right here. 4. I need 4. So I'm going to put that, and I'm going to say, well, there's 4 more to get to 10. And then this is super awesome, because I'm already at 10. How many more to get to 13? Well, 3, because 10 and 3 is 13. So the difference between 6 and 13 it's not 4, it's not 3, it's this whole thing. So I'd have to add 4 and 3 together, and that's close to a double. It's not 8, but it's 7. Okay? So all these blue ones, we can work it in a way while we're figuring out where that 10 is to help us find the difference. Okay? And then the last set of problems are called the leftover facts. And look at all the leftovers we have. We have quite a bit, the ones that are not shaded in. And these ones that are not shaded, you just have to figure out a good strategy for yourself. Like, what could I do to help me get an answer quickly and efficiently? So if I have something like 18 and I'm subtracting off 5, how are you gonna think about that? Is it good? Are you gonna like to count back? Are you going to like to find the difference between a 5 and an 18 on a number line by looking at where 10 is? Like, what feels comfortable to you? For me, I kind of like thinking about this one as 8 minus 5. If I know that one, the difference between 5 and 8 is 3, then I can take that idea into 18 minus 5 and just say, well, it's 3 with the 10, 13. Right? So you decide what works for you. And in order to get better at your subtraction facts, you just need to practice your subtraction facts, okay? All right, you can do it. Be awesome.